Our artist today is Carla Sanchez. Carla Sanchez was born and raised in Mexico, and just beautiful, beautiful art. We have some pieces of hers downstairs that we'd be more than happy to show you if you're interested. We have a couple of Catrinas that we have. They're just absolutely beautiful. She used to make these altars as a contest in Mexico when she was younger, and then went on to actually judge them in for the schools. So without further ado, Carla Sanchez, thank you.
Thank you, gracias. Hola, buenas tardes a todos. Mi nombre es Carla Sanchez, como ya lo oyeron. Yo vengo aquí para darles una explicación de lo que es el altar de muertos.
Hi, my name is Carla Sanchez, and I'm here to give you an introduction to what is the Day of the Dead.
Normalmente, el altar de muertos está constituido por siete niveles.
Normally, the altar for our dead is constructed of seven levels.
Esto fue desde antes de la conquista.
That was before the conquest, even.
Pero continúa siendo todavía hasta nuestros días los siete niveles que constan de lo tradicional de un altar.
But it continues to be part of our tradition, the seven levels.
El primer nivel,
the first level,
es la presentación de llamar a las almas.
It's the level of the construction to be able to call the spirits.
Que se suponía,
and it was assumed,
que pasaban por el primer nivel cruzando el artículo lo religioso, que era la bienvenida hacia el alma.
And basically, it was presumed that they would come through the first level, and it would be an invitation, a religious invitation for the spirits to come.
Antes de la conquista,
before the conquest,
el primer nivel,
the first level,
estaba dedicado a Huitzilopochtli.
Was dedicated to
Huitzilopochtli, que era el dios de la guerra,
which was the god of war.
Pero cuando llegaron los españoles,
but when the Spaniards arrived,
quisieron quitar los altares de muertos.
They wanted to take away the altars for the dead.
Lo único que pudieron hacer fue cambiar de sus antiguos dioses a lo que fue el cristianismo, que es lo que conocemos ahora como la cruz y los santos.
And what they were able to take away were the gods that from before, but they were able to keep the Christianity and keep our saints and so on.
El siguiente nivel,
the following level,
es para las almas del purgatorio,
are for the spirits in purgatory,
que sería donde llegaba ya cansado el alma de purgar, que venías a hacer que llegaba ya el espíritu cansado de purgar por más de un año, que era lo que regresaba otra vez hacia el Día de Muertos.
Which was basically when the spirit would come after being in purgatory for a year or so, and the spirit was tired.
Por eso existen los elementos del agua.
That's why we have water.
El agua donde se suponía que llegaba, tomaba agua y descansaba un poco.
Where it was presumed that he would drink some water and would rest for a while.
El siguiente nivel,
the next level,
es el de arreglo personal,
is the one of personal grooming.
¿Por qué arreglo personal? Porque llegaba supuestamente cansado de recorrer todo ese camino, sediento, despeinado, sucio. Por eso había su jabón, su peine y su espejo, para que se reconociera en el espejo y supiera que era él.
Why personal grooming? Well, it was presumed that the spirit would arrive tired, worn, and so on. So we would place then the personal items for him to be able to groom himself, wash himself, and always a mirror so that he would be able to recognize himself.
El siguiente nivel,
the next level,
es el de las fotografías, el que va dedicado, a quien va dedicado es el, todo el altar.
Is the level where we have the pictures. Who is the altar dedicated to?
Aquí se ven todas las fotografías de las personas que ya murieron y que se dedica el altar.
So we see all the pictures of the people that have passed and for whom the altar is for.
El siguiente nivel es el nivel de la comida y la bebida.
And the next level is the level of the food and the drinks.
Se suponía que si se ponía la comida, era la comida que al muerto le gustaba o que, digamos, que a la persona fallecida le había gustado en vida, entonces debía de haber la comida de su preferencia.
So it was presumed that the food that would be left, that would be put out, would be those favorite foods of the people that had passed, mostly for the food that they liked most.
El siguiente nivel.
The next level.
Es ya el último nivel donde se suponía que ya era donde se despedía.
It's the last level where there would be a farewell.
Otra vez tenía que estar tanto al principio del altar como al final el símbolo religioso.
Just like in the beginning of the altar, at the end there would be a religious symbol, the religious symbol of Christianity.
En el último nivel del altar podemos ver una vara.
In the last level, we can see a wand.
Una vara, como un stick.
So a stick, a wand. So.
Que los antiguos mayas, tutunecas y mexicas creían que tenía que haber una vara al final para que se pudieran defender de las almas, de los demonios al salir del altar.
The past civilizations, Mayans,
Mexicas,
Tabascos, they would want a weapon so that they could protect themselves or defend themselves from the demons.
Y ya así poder volver a lo que era llamado el Mixtlán.
And that way be able to return to what was called Mixtlán.
¿Alguna pregunta?
So is there a question?
¿Nos puedes explicar un poco sobre los significantes de los símbolos como la cadena, el papel picado, por qué tantas velas, las calaveras?
So the question was if she could explain a little bit about the other symbols such as the chain and the other symbols that are present.
La cadena es los colores que se utilizaron después de la conquista.
So the chain is made up of colors that were used after the conquest.
Y es amarillo y morado porque el morado significaba la muerte y el amarillo era la vida.
And it's yellow and purple because the purple signified death and the yellow signified life.
Que era la cuestión punta de entre la vida y la muerte.
Which was a matter, which was basically joint. They were together.
Entre la vida y la muerte, por eso era todo el altar de traer hacia los muertos, hacia el lugar donde estaban los vivos.
And that was one of the purposes of the altar, to bring the dead to where the people that were alive were.
Las velas, sobre todo las velas grandes, que son las que se encuentran al final donde está la comida, se suponía que eran para alumbrar la última salida.
The candles, but more importantly, the big candles at the last level, was so that they could
alumbrar,
to be able to lighten the path,
sí, de salida,
to of their exit.
Igualmente, las velas que están al comenzar el altar es para alumbrar el camino. Todas las velas tienen su parte esencial en un altar, porque es alumbrar el camino del alma que entraba, o del muerto, como decimos en
en México, ¿verdad?
Just like the candles at the beginning, they all have a significance where they're guiding the dead or our people that have passed. They all signify they're lighting the way to the from the entrance to the exit.
Hola, mi nombre es Carla Sanchez. You know, today we make the opening for the Day of the Dead. It's November 2, and for me, doing the Altar de Muertos is very, very important because it's coming with my traditions in Mexico. You know, it's been more like my culture, my parents, my grandma, remember everybody who passed away. Today is the day to remember. This altar is very, very traditional. It's like you see in Mexico. It's the real, real, real thing. Thank you. The Hispanic Center has given me the opportunity to show everybody how is get a real traditional altar. They be working very, very close with the community, especially with the Hispanic community. We always try to keep the traditions alive. Even so you are not in USA, you know, we try to keep it our tradition. This is the way with the Hispanic Center show to the community, especially the Hispanic community, how we keep it all these traditions alive.